Hello friends, in the last video we deployed the Medusa 2.0 stack with my railway deploy template. And we're left with a working storefront and a working backend connected with a Postgres database. If you have not watched the previous video, I'll leave a link to it. It's very easy to follow, and in about just 5 minutes by using the deploy template, you will have a stack just like the one I have here with a hosted backend and a hosted storefront. And this is required to proceed with the tutorial. Unless you have a different Medusa project that you started yourself in another way, and you just want to follow this video to see how you add Stripe to your project, that should also be possible. Let's go to the storefront and go to the public URL. And this is where we ended up after deploying it. It's very basic, not much to see. There's the demo products, and the next natural thing would probably be to facilitate some sort of a checkout flow, and that's not possible currently. So if I go to my cart, I've added one t-shirt, the one I changed the product title in the last video for, and I click go to checkout, and I've pre-filled some shipping information, chosen a standard shipping method, and you'll see on the payment it says manual payment. So if I click this, nothing happens. And that's a problem. We need the customers to be able to pay somehow, and the most natural way would be with some sort of a credit card. At least in my parts of the world, this is how webshop works. And Stripe comes in very handy here because it facilitates credit card payments across a lot of different countries and regions around the world. So we want to add Stripe to our Medusa project so our customers can check out products or services or whatever you're selling using a credit card. And if we go to the Medusa.js documentation, you see that they already have a module for Stripe with some documentation. So I followed this to get it to work, but I've also installed Stripe on a previous Medusa 1.0 project, so I know a little bit about how it works. If you use my deploy template, it's going to be quite easy for you because I already pre-installed the module, so you don't have to do this. And I also pre-configured the module in the Medusa config, so you also don't have to do this part. But if you have a project that was not made with the deploy template, this is what you have to do. In the backend project, you have to install add Medusa.js payment Stripe at preview, and then you have to add this part to your configuration. So a module, a payment module, and it has to look exactly like this. You can just copy it. There's one more thing that they are forgetting here. So they say you need to provide an API key, but you actually also need to give it a webhook secret. So if we go to my GitHub, I have it open right here. I'll leave a link to it in the video description so you can follow it. And you see it's in backend and Medusa config. And I added this here, webhook secret, and I'm passing in both the Stripe API key and the webhook secret with process environment variables, and I give them through Railway, and we'll get to that later. But if you follow the deploy template, you already have all this, you don't have to worry about it. But if you have a Medusa project in another way, you need to add this module and install the plugin with this command right here. Okay, so now we're ready to move on. I'll show you now the next thing that you need to do is to obtain the Stripe API key and the Stripe API webhook secret. So we go over to stripe.com. And I'm already signed in. If you don't have a Stripe account, you need to create one. It's stripe.com. And during the process of creating an account, you also need to create like a little business unit. And I actually have a video from half a year ago over on my blog. I will make sure to leave a link to that. And in this video, I'm configuring Stripe for another project. It's a venture web shop. And about 2 minutes into the video, which is a little bit down the page, I'm actually going through the entire process of creating the account. So if you're struggling with the account creation, you can go and watch this video and see how it's done. And once that's done, you'll have a dashboard that looks something like this. I am in test mode, which is quite essential for making testing credit card transactions that they are working. So I encourage you to turn on test mode before going ahead. And we can start with the API key. So if you head over to developers and API key, and there will be a publishable API key, which we need for later, but not now. And then there's the secret key, and it's the secret key that we need to provide to the backend. So what I will do is I will go back to my GitHub repository and I'll copy this name of the variable to my clipboard. I'll go back to my Railway project. I'll take my backend and go to variables and I will add one. And the name is Stripe API key. And then we need the key from Stripe. So I'm going to click reveal and I'm going to click it and it's now on my clipboard. Go back and I'll add it right here and click add. So now we have one change, but we need one more. We also need the webhook. And for the to create the webhook, we need our URL. And this is the URL on Railway. So if you're hosting your Medusa project on Vercel or DigitalOcean or any other platform, you need to find the public URL of your backend. I'll copy it to clipboard, go back to Stripe, and I'll go to webhooks. And then we click add endpoint. And then we need to paste in our URL here. And it needs to start with https://. And then we need to add something to the end as well. So if we go back to the documentation, you'll see here it says, this is one of these very nice where you cannot select text. I'll copy it from here. But you need to add /hooks/payment/stripe. So let's add that. And then we also need to add some events. And I must admit that I found this event by searching with Perplexity. So I asked Perplexity what events I needed, and it told me that I needed the payment intent succeeded. So I'll search for that. Payment intent succeeded. And then we need two more. So we need one that's called amount capturable update. I'll add that. And then the last one is payment failed. So here, and then you see it added these three events here. I cannot say with 100% certainty that you don't need any more events or that this will change, but it's easy to update this later on. For now, I'll say add events, and then we're ready to add our endpoint. So if you need to make changes in the future, you can simply just click update details. Okay, next we need to give it the secret for this webhook. So I'll go back to my GitHub right here, and it was Stripe webhook secret. I'll copy that to clipboard, and we add one more variable. So Stripe webhook secret, go back to Stripe, reveal. I'll copy it to clipboard and paste it in here, and I will add it. Okay, so now we have the two required inputs for the backend. That was the API key and the webhook secret, but the storefront also needs something. So I select the storefront and we will add a variable and it's called next public Stripe key. I have it here so I can paste it in. And the way I found this was actually searching the source code of the storefront project. So I searched for Stripe underscore and I found here in the readme that this is what you need to use if you want to use Stripe, and apparently you can also use PayPal. It seems like the storefront comes already with Stripe. Let's see here, it has already Stripe and it has also some sort of PayPal module. So I think the user interface of the webshop can support also PayPal, but we're just focusing on Stripe here. So I'm going to add next public Stripe key, and we find that by going back to our Stripe dashboard, click developers and API keys, and this is the publishable one, so it doesn't have to be secret. That's why it's not blurred out. You shouldn't be worried about sharing that with anyone. We put it right here and I click add. So now we have three changes. I'll hit deploy and I'll pause the video and come back as soon as these changes have been deployed. 3 minutes later, and we have now deployed the changes. I'll just verify that they're here. Next publishable key, and on the backend, we have now the webhook secret and the API key. Good. So we need to do a little bit of configuration in our backend. So I'll go over and open my admin dashboard /app, and I'm already logged in. See, I made a test order yesterday and it says authorized because the Stripe payment worked. What you need to do is you need to go to settings and then you need to find regions. And under your default region, or if you have more regions, you need to probably configure it on all of them, but I only have Europe right here. So I'll go into Europe and I will click edit. And then we see this payment providers. And this is where we can now add Stripe. So Stripe Ideal would be a good thing to use in my parts of the world because a lot of people use Ideal. But I'm just going to select the basic Stripe one. And this is basically just credit card numbers. I'll click save. Yeah, and it says it was updated. So we should in theory be able to go back to the storefront where we were for before here with the manual payment. And if I update it, hopefully we'll see credit card. And we do. So that's a really good sign. And remember that we toggled on this test mode here, and that allows us to check that the integration with Stripe is correctly configured. And the test credit card number that you can use is 42 42 42 42 42 42 42 42, and then here 1 2 3 4, and then any numbers for the code and the zip. So I'll just put these in. I'll click continue to review. And it says it's a Visa card. So I think already now it's confirmed that it worked, but let's click the final button and see that we get a confirmation, and we did. This is great. Thank you for your order. If we go back to our backend and we go to out of settings, there is now an order for John Doe. Let's now verify the transaction on Stripe. So I'll go over and click on transaction. It gives me to this page. And I'll click the most top one, and I can see that was made just a few minutes ago, so this must be the one. If I scroll a little bit down, I can definitely see that it was made by John Doe, and we can see here the credit card numbers were the test credit card numbers. So I think this demonstrates that the Stripe integration is now fully working. Remember though that in order for you to actually get money and do this on a production environment, you need to do it all over again by toggling off the test mode. When you toggle off the test mode, you will have to import your, so we go to developers and webhook, and then you'll have to import, so you can import your test endpoints here, and then you'll have to go to API key and provide the real API key, not the one you got from the test mode. But it is exactly the same process, except the test mode is turned off. But then you're in real business, and actual money will be charged from credit cards used, and you cannot use the test credit card. I have added a little blog post here to my blog, or it's not published yet, but it will be by the time of the video. And I'll add in the video here, but here you find all the links for all the tabs that I've had open throughout the video. So that's the Medusa Stripe documentation, there's the GitHub repo, and here is the link to the video where I create the Stripe account. So if you have trouble creating a Stripe account, you should watch from 1 minute 30 seconds until 6 minutes. And there's actually some important details that you need to fill in for your account to be accepted. So if you have problems registering your account, you can go and watch this video where I do it. Here's the link to the Medusajs 2.0 deploy template in case you missed it. And here is everything that you need for copy pasting. So all the URLs, the payment events, the environment variables. I think that's all for the demonstration with Stripe. Another thing I wanna mention is on the initial blog post where we start this whole Medusa 2.0 journey. This is where you found the deploy template. I keep updating this blog post, and I've added something to the bottom, and that is what next? So you've successfully deployed, and now you want to customize and personalize it to your business case or hobby product needs, whatever. So I've added some resources here. There's a category of self-help and ask for help. And in the self-help, you'll find link to the documentation, the official Medusa documentation. And I've added some links to videos of other creators that show you how you implement stuff in Medusa 2.0. There's not that many videos. Most on YouTube are Medusa 1.0. So it's really nice that Alex is making a few videos, and I've linked some of his videos here, so you can see how to create a notification provider module, and also how you can implement authentication with Kind. And I'll also add in here my Stripe integration, and more will be coming in the future. Then there is the category ask for help, and I've put links to the Medusa.js community Discord. So if you wanna ask Medusa related questions, you can do it here. There's also a link to a forum thread where you can, if you have any issues regarding the deploy template itself, you can ask them here. And then there is a more general railway community. So if you have any other questions regarding hosting on railway, how to do stuff, if you get any error messages, this is where you can ask for help with railway related issues. I think that concludes this video. Have a nice day.